United. Welcome back to the Rory Talks Football channel, your daily Arsenal news, updates, debates, and my opinions. As Arsenal are top of the Premier League, Liverpool have blinked first, and it is a sensational Sunday evening. I hope you're all doing very well. If you're new to the channel, please do subscribe. We're on our way to 10,000 subscribers. The support on the channel recently, I massively appreciate. If you could like the video as well, whether you're watching on catch up or you're live right now, please do click that like button. Spread the video to as many people as possible because it really does help. Loads of you in the chat already. It's unusual for us to go live on a Sunday evening, but I was just in the mood for it. Pekka, Fizzy, Jake, Darwin Godnez, GGF, Sei, Drax, Carter, SS9, Sal, Tom, Ross Lawman, President Bozo, SS9 Ultra Pro Gamer, Hannah, Verdi, Andreas, Magnus, Pontus, Apod, Francisco Oliveira. It is good to see you all. Millie, Jack Sacks as well. Isaki, Leo Nesbitt, and Shikar. It is good to see you all. Loads of you in here. I can't even pronounce. It's pronounced Shay. I'm sorry, Shay. It's pronounced Shay. Cobby Mainoo. Get him on the plane, Gareth. He doesn't need to play. Just get him on the plane. He's earned it. He has earned it. What a game. I'll tell you what, honestly, I'm so glad I'm not a United fan. I'm so glad I'm not a United fan because that 90 minutes, I was screaming. Do you know what? If you watched the watch-along of the Brighton game yesterday, we were so calm all game. You know, even before we took the lead, it was all just relatively calm. Matt, that game, I am screaming at United players. Casemiro, I mean, honestly, I was screaming at him to just run. Just engage the sprint button, please. But it was. Look, we got there in the end. I mean, it's frustrating, really, that Wan-Bissaka gave away such a pointless penalty. Like, it's a terrible penalty to give away. And if United did need the 3 points. And I guess if you're a United fan, you'd be annoyed about that. But we'll take 2 points dropped. We'll take being top of the league. It is all good. Fido, thank you very much. That game was mutual destruction. Yeah, it was. It was just, I mean, Liverpool seriously cost themselves because not only did they give the equaliser to United, right? Gerald Kwanza, terrible mistake. But also, they should have been 3-0 up, 4-0 up by halftime. The game should have been dead and buried before halftime. So, Elliot dive. Yeah, do you know what, right? It was a dive. You know, it was a dive because the initial challenge from Wan-Bissaka doesn't actually make contact. And then what Elliot sort of basically leaves his right leg there and inevitably falls over Wan-Bissaka's body, which is just on the floor. The only reason I'm not massively going to complain about it is because it is such a stupid challenge that it deserved to give away a penalty. It's one of those where it was just such a ridiculous challenge. But I do think it was a dive. Realistically, it was a dive. But there's, you know, it is what it is. It is what it is. Just such a stupid challenge. Was just on TFT, on the Football Terrace, where Terry showed a video where it's clear that the pen was a clear dive. Yeah, I do. Look, United fans can definitely be angry about it. United fans can be angry about it. Where is all the pool week mentality and Callahan off his line and mistakes from pundits like we got last season? Oh, yeah, you won't hear any of it. You won't hear any of it. And by the way, I'm pretty sure, unless I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure Konate was on the bench, I believe. Was Konate on the bench? Let me check. Yeah, see, Konate was on the bench. This guy that Liverpool fans will try and tell you is better than William Saliba was on the bench. And Jurgen Klopp made the decision to play Kwanzaa. And do you know what? Kwanzaa looked pretty shaky all game. Not just for the goal that they conceded. Earlier on in the game, he gave the ball away, which probably should have ended up in a goal when he gave it to Bruno. You know, there were quite a few moments where you just think, why is Kwanzaa playing ahead of Konate in a game like this? It was an interesting one. And that's on Klopp. How is Willy Kambwala's performance today? Really good. Really good. I mean, again, look, there were some moments where you're like, okay, he's a bit raw. But overall, very good. And do you know what he had that United are screaming out for was just a bit of passion? And you don't want to be passion merchants, but he at least, you know, every time he did something, he was revving up the crowd. He was giving it. That's what you need. Spurs 1-0. Yeah, it is currently Sheffield United 1, Chelsea 1. Just kicked off the second half in that game. And Tottenham Hotspur 1, Nottingham Forest 1. So a couple of games to keep an eye on there. Maybe he wasn't totally fit. Maybe Konate's not totally fit, I suppose. But then you wouldn't put him on the bench, would you? I don't know. Are you confident about the title? More confident than I was at the start of today. Because not only have Liverpool dropped points there, but I'm looking at that United performance going, United away, when we've got the title, you know, potentially in our hands. You know, if we get to United away, which is the penultimate game of the season, and we're still leading the Premier League, I back us to go there and win. Like, they were so bad. And in transitions, you look at the way we transition against teams and cut through midfields. Well, I can't imagine a more easy midfield to cut through than the Manchester United one at the moment. Casemiro is just unbelievably poor. Klopp said Arsenal will beat United if they play like that in his press conference. Yeah, he's right. He's right. Like, Liverpool should have been 3 or 4-0 up. They really should. Liverpool forwards are overrated. Their decision making is shit. It is poor. Salah's been poor. Darwin Nunez was poor today. Diaz could have scored right at the end, but he blazed it over. Cobby's goal was unbelievable. Do you know, it's kind of as well, it's the audacity of him. It's the audacity of him to just go for that and pull it off. And it's not the first time he's done it this season. Remember Wolves away. It was a huge goal. Salah is living up to the Tom Garrett allegations. Well, to an extent, yeah. Look, I do think like Salah is older. You know, he is older, and he's beginning to look his age a little bit at this point. How do you feel about Arsenal's chance of winning the league after this Liverpool performance? Yeah, I mean, it's undoubtedly better, right? And this today was an example of the unsustainable Liverpool finally being unsustainable. You cannot get away with it every single time. And they have been getting away with it. Let's be real. They have been getting away with it. You know, against Sheffield United, they relied on an absolute worldie from McAllister. They're not dominating games. They're not putting games to bed. You know, they went 1-0 up against Sheffield United, conceded. And I think this will knock their confidence as well. I do think that will knock their confidence going into future games. So, great question. And the answer is City. I'm more worried about City than Liverpool because I still see Liverpool dropping more points this season. They have a horrible away run. Like, away from home, they just look shaky. And they've got a run where in the space of 10 days, they play away against Atalanta in the Europa League. And then they play Fulham, West Ham and Everton all away from home, all in the space of 10 days. So I do still think they'll drop more points. Whereas City, even though I still, you know, I look at City yesterday, I still don't think they're brilliant. I can see them winning every game from now until the end of the season. Like, it's a City thing. Rashford was actually good today. He had heart today. Rashford actually looked like he wanted to be there today. He was going for it, which was good to see. I still think some of his decision-making could have been a bit better. But overall, he had a good game. But he did go off injured. So I don't know what that injury is or how long he'll be out for. But where do you see Arsenal dropping points? Spurs away. Spurs away, we face them after a really tough run of games. And they have a 15-day break. So they have a 15-day break. And during that 15-day break, we play 4 games. And they're tough games as well. So that'll be a tough one. Villa at home's not going to be a walk in the park next weekend. And really, that's it. Spurs away, Villa at home. Outside of that, we shouldn't be dropping points anywhere. I don't really look at United away as a place where I'm worried that we drop points, looking at that performance today. Wolves could be a banana. Yeah, there's a lot of those ones like Wolves that could be a banana skin. You look at it and you go, you know, Wolves is a potential banana skin because of the games we have before it. We have a lot of really difficult games before it. And the example I used from last season was, remember like January last season, we went through a really tough run of games where we didn't lose any of them. We did well in a really tough run of games. I think it was like Spurs, Newcastle. Yeah, it was like Newcastle, Spurs away, something and something. I can't remember exactly what it was. We had a really tough run of games, and then we had Everton, who at the time were terrible. And we dropped points, and it was like, it felt like we dropped points because the team had kind of gone, oh, we've just got through that really tough period. Sigh of relief. And that's where the Wolves game could be a problem, but we'll see. Were you on TIFO for the game today? No, I didn't in the end. I didn't go live for the game. I've been trying to get a ticket for the Bayern game, like desperately trying to get a ticket. So I didn't go live for the game in the end, but I think we are above slipping in games like Wolves away. We should be. We should be above it for sure. And the way we're playing at the moment, you know, you look at games like yesterday, Brighton away is a tough place. It's a tough place for everyone, but it's been especially tough for us previously. And Brighton in general has been tough for us previously. I don't know what you're spamming, but you're going to get put in timeout. I don't know what that was. There was a few people on Twitter to your... Yeah, but a lot of them are not real. A lot of them are not real. Or they're like, oh, yeah, I can help you get a ticket. And then it turns out it's like one of their mates had a ticket 4 days ago that they don't have anymore. I've had a lot of them. I had someone, fair play to him. He was trolling me, led me a merry dance, thinking I was going to get a ticket. And then right at the end, just sent a load of laughing emojis and said, ha, 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 fuck off, United, United, United. So it's been a brutal afternoon trying to get a ticket, but we are where we are. I think it was better with a draw today. If United got 3 points and they in some way got into the top four race, when we faced them with the draw today, that is now no chance. So yeah, possibly. You might be right. The new eight is more important than a new striker, in my opinion. Possibly. I do think it's becoming closer. I do think it's becoming closer because you do still look at it and you go, even with how well Jorginho's been playing, even if Thomas Partey comes back into it, we don't have a long-term Rice partner at the club at the moment because neither Partey or Jorginho are long-term. How that Diaz attack in the last minute not giving us ball was so far out. I know, I was fuming. If that had ended up in a goal from that final free kick, I would have lost my head. Oh, I would have lost my head. The TikTok content I'd have been making out of that would have been unbelievable because the ball was so far out and they didn't give it. Gyökeres miles over Isak. I don't think it's Miles, but I do put Gyökeres ahead. By the way, I was on Gyökeres watch last night. To be fair, it wasn't one of his better games. Sporting against Benfica at the top of the Portuguese league, and Sporting won it in the 90th minute, which like didn't guarantee that they win the title, but it put them in a really good position. But even in a game like that, like it wasn't one of Gyökeres's best games, but he's relentless. Gyökeres ahead because of injury availability. Yeah, I do agree with that. Thoughts on the game? Is it in our hands now? Well, by definition, it is in our hands. And I tweeted this before I went live. Like, everyone that said that Arsenal should have gone for the win against City, that Arsenal should have gambled, this result today has completely proven Mikel Arteta correct. It has completely justified what we did and how we did it. We went there, we made sure we got a point, and we didn't gamble. Because people make out, oh, Arsenal should have gone for it, as if by going for it, we'd have guaranteed the win. But equally, we'd have risked the loss. Had we lost that game at the Etihad, we'd be in third now. We'd be in third in the title race behind City and Liverpool. Because we drew that game, we're now top of the table. The season is in our hands. The title is in our hands. And every game we've got left, including Spurs away, is still an easier game than the Etihad. So completely justified to go and do what we did at the Etihad. And people said, oh yeah, but you had the chance to go top if you'd beaten them. All we had to do was make an educated guess that Liverpool wouldn't win every single game until the end of the season. And it took two games for that to be proven correct. So it was, you know, it was, like you said, Jake, it was another Mikel Arteta, I told you so. Do you think a City-esque run-in is possible for us, not dropping a single point for the rest of the season? it's possible, right? Anything's possible. The way we're playing, you look at it and you go, I don't know how we're going to lose a game. You do look at the way we're playing, defensively especially, I don't know how we're going to lose a game. But having said that, we've got an incredibly tough run, including the Champions League. If we were to put on a run like City and go from now until the end of the season winning every game, it would actually be better than anything City have ever done in terms of a run of games at the end of the season. Because if we were to do that, that would ultimately mean that in our final 18 games of the season, we'd have won 17 and drawn one, with that draw being at the Etihad. Because we're already on a run of 11 games played, 10 wins, one draw. I'm a Coventry fan and Gyökeres is insane. Yeah, I mean, do you have you don't need to spam the message, Madfoot, but do you have a sell-on clause? Do Coventry have a sell-on clause if we buy him? Because if we're looking at buying him for 100 million euros and you've got a sell-on clause, you'd be rubbing your hands together. Did you see George Scaife slandering Benny Blanco on TikTok, saying he should have been banned for 3 games for diving after he got a hand on the throat? Yeah, look, George Scaife is it's hilarious. Because, by the way, if a Liverpool player did what Benny Blanco did and an Arsenal fan was saying it should be a 3-match ban, George Scaife would kick right off at them. So I think George is feeling the pressure of the title race as much as he tries to believe that he's not. There is a sell-on clause. There is a sell-on clause. Yeah, Howland, if you didn't know this, I think I did mention it in my video yesterday, Douglas Luiz is out of the game against Arsenal. 10 yellow cards, 2-match suspension, out of the game against Arsenal. And he picked up that yellow card in the 97th minute, which was absolutely sensational. So Douglas Luiz not going to be in the squad to face Arsenal. So, and look, the way Villa capitulated against Brentford at home yesterday, you know, we should be beating them. We should be beating them. Who's the favourite on Tuesday? Arsenal, by the, you know, judging the bookies, the betting odds, and, you know, realistically, the way that we're playing, Arsenal are the favourites. You know, Arsenal are in great form on a great run. Bayern lost 3-2 against Heidenheim. So Arsenal are 100% the favourites. Who do you think will win, City or Madrid? I think City will win. No. I actually reckon Madrid might win. Just looking at the amount of goals that Man City have been conceding, especially without Kyle Walker, any team that's got pace on the break when they haven't got Kyle Walker, they're getting torn apart. And I'm looking at Vinicius Jr. being, you know, thread through by Jude Bellingham. I think City could be in trouble, actually. Tuesday is going to play with my nerves no matter what the result is. Yeah, it's going to be crazy. Luis doesn't want to upset his next club. Maybe. He's done us a favour. Who's injured for Bayern? We'll get into this in the preview show tomorrow, but from what I saw today, Manuel Neuer is going to be fit. Leroy Sané is going to be fit. Kingsley Coman has is going to have a fitness test tomorrow. So Neuer and Sané are back. Coman's going to have a fitness test. But they'll have another press conference, as will Arteta, tomorrow. So we'll talk about that on the stream tomorrow night with more information. Did you see Dalman's wonder goal yesterday? He's our next Wilshire. Yeah, look, if you've not seen Dalman, he's in the Arsenal Academy. He's only recently turned 14 years old, and he's absolutely tearing it up for the under-18s now. Scored a goal yesterday. The ball came to him on his left foot. He feigned sort of outside the box, feigned as if he was going to shoot with his left foot. Ball rolled it past the defender with the fake shot, like a fake shot ball roll past the defender, and then whipped it into the far corner at 14 years old. Look, you can never truly judge a player that young and know what's going to come of them, but he looks like a serious talent for sure. Luis decided to duck the rice test. Yeah. And I mean, if we go and look at the team that Villa were playing with yesterday. In fact, I can bring this up on the screen. I'll bring this up on the screen for you now. Villa's team yesterday. Luiz, Tielemans, McGinn, Watkins. They've got this guy Rogers out on the left. Without Luiz in there and looking at their bench, I don't know who's going to play because Kamara's out for the season. Jacob Ramsey is out of that game, not going to be back until May. So I don't know who's actually going to play. I guess they'll maybe have to put John McGinn deeper alongside. But for me, McGinn and Tielemans in the midfield, it's not strong. It's not strong, to be honest with you. So they are going to come to the Emirates with a relatively weakened team, which is quite beneficial. Still 1-1 in the Sheffield United and Chelsea and the Tottenham and Forest games. Graham Watkins, boom! Come on, you Gunners. Exactly. Arteta told Luis, miss the game and I'll sign you. Yeah, literally. He's done it. He's taken one for the team. Fair play to him. A very slow midfield. Yeah, the Rodgers guy is very good. I saw his goal. His goal was very good, to be fair. Will you do a watch-along if you can't go to the game on Tuesday? I will, but if I refuse to accept not going to the game. Like, I will be there. By hook or by crook. No matter how much money I have to spend, I will be there. Thoughts on that Crystal Palace midfielder? Which one? Wharton? Adam Wharton? Or a different one? I will do, if I don't get to the game, I will do a watch along. Why don't you just buy a resale? I refuse. To be fair, I say by hook or by crook, I'd refuse to buy off a reseller. And this is the annoying thing, right? Across resale sites, there are nearly 1,000 tickets for the Arsenal game, and the cheapest one's like £400. And it's like, it's just ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. What's the next challenge? You'll have to wait and see. You'll have to wait and see what the next challenge is. I'm going to start it tomorrow. Tomorrow I've got to go to Manchester for a podcast. So I'm out for most of the day tomorrow. So I don't want to start the new challenge tomorrow. I'll maybe start it on Tuesday, but then on Tuesday we've got the game. So maybe it starts on Wednesday. I'm not sure yet. Can you buy tickets on third-party resales or does the club block? Well, this is the other thing. If you go and buy a ticket off a resale site, you're paying minimum £400, basically, and you're really not guaranteed the ticket. Like, there are so many of them that end up scamming you, or you turn up and the ticket doesn't work. And the club can ban you. Yeah, it's maybe with enough super chats you can afford the £400. Nah, the super chats. I'm not risking the super chats on a gamble ticket. The super chats go towards, well, as it stands, a new camera. But we'll see how many more streams we get through without another crash before deciding which way it's going to go. The Jota montage was jokes. Yeah, to be fair, I was actually helped out with that Jota montage. Someone on TikTok, and credit to them, did a video of all 75 days just with the bit where I lost. But it meant that it was like a 3-minute video that I could watch it through. And then it showed me which ones were the Jota ones. So I wrote down which days were the Jota days, which made it way faster for me to go back and make that compilation of me versus Jota. And look, that's not the final dance. That is, you know, they sell tickets for the Ronaldo Messi, the last dance. Me and Jota will dance again. We will. That's so wrong, the fact that people have stolen tickets from proper fans and then don't even go, but just get £500 off it. Yeah, it happens all the time. Can see Rory loitering around the stadium for a scalper. To be fair, the scalpers barely exist anymore. It used to be, right? Every time you came out of Arsenal Station, on the way from Arsenal Station, well, pretty much straight outside the station, you'd have quite a few people stood there selling tickets, right? They'd be like, anyone trying to buy a ticket? Anyone buying a ticket? Selling a ticket? These days, the people outside the stadium themselves are the ones that are trying to buy the tickets. They're out there going, anyone got a ticket? Which is crazy. Just looked on FanPass and a ticket is going for £381. Yeah, it's like £370, £380 is the cheapest I've seen. What did I say about Liverpool? I can't remember word for word what you said about Liverpool, but I'm assuming you predicted that they would drop points. £199 from Brennan McAdams. Thank you very, very much for that £199 super chat. ETA until you start your gaming streams. ETA till I start my... Soon. I should give myself a deadline, really. I do need to buy a new camera. I need to buy a new camera. How long's that? I don't know how long it's going to take. It shouldn't take too long. To be honest, look, we have a few more days like we did in the Luton preview, and we won't be far away. Did you see that we're interested in young Barca defender? He's Senegalese. I'm not sure who that is, but I haven't seen it. Can we get a pro clubs? Yeah, I might start a pro clubs, to be fair. How much is the ticket from the Arsenal site? The cheapest ones are like 60 quid. To be fair, right? So I've been spamming the ticket exchange, desperately trying. And on the ticket exchange, the only ticket I've seen come up so far was a halfway line club level ticket. It was 350 quid and it went instantly, which just shows you how much, you know, how many people are trying to buy tickets. The fact that one for 350, which is the most expensive ticket exchange ticket I've ever seen, went like that and didn't get relisted. Crazy. I saw you almost crying on your TikTok. What happened? I don't know, John. What was the TikTok? If it was about me getting a ticket, it was just me crying about not getting a ticket. But Chelsea have taken a 2-1 lead. Noni Madueke. I tell you what, right? Would you take Noni Madueke? Because I've seen him a few times, and don't get me wrong, he's a bit rough around the edges, and he's not as good. He's not as good as some of the other options out there. But Noni Madueke is a player that I look at, and I'm like, well. Did you see Murillo's shot from 70 yards that just went wide? I didn't. Why aren't you a season ticket holder? I've been waiting. Ever since I turned an adult, because obviously I wasn't born in London, didn't grow up in London, didn't really know if I'd ever be able to move to London. And so until I was like, okay, I am going to move to London, I never joined the waiting list for the season ticket. So now I've been on the season ticket waiting list for, I think it's like 7 years. And I'm still 47,000 in the queue. I started at 120,000th in the queue. I'm now 47,000th in the queue. But like at the end of last season, it literally didn't move. Like the most recent season, I went from 47,000 to 47,000, which is mental. Hell no, no more Chelsea players. I mean, you say no more Chelsea players, and I kind of agree because previously, getting players like David Luiz, Petr Cech, it hadn't really gone well for us. But now, you know, Jorginho and Havertz yesterday cooking up a bit of a storm. So I'm not completely against it. Mafia Boss, good to see you. Rory, my dad got offered a season ticket by the club in 2019, but he declined. I got offered a club-level season ticket a couple of years ago. I think early on last season. But it was like $3,500 and I just couldn't afford it. I'm at 14,000-ish in the queue, been waiting so many years. Yeah, same. I'll take Palmer for a Nelson backup. The disrespect. United. I actually wanted to go through. We don't normally get to do this anymore because the games come so thick and fast that we actually don't have time to run through Arteta's interview from after the game. But I figure we'll just scan through Mikel Arteta's press conference after the game yesterday. He was asked about winning emphatically. He just said, really happy, really proud of the boys. They put in a big performance. They haven't lost here since August, and that tells you the difficulty of it. And that is a bit mental. Havertz's performance. He said he's certainly having a huge impact on the team. I think his overall performances have been really good. And now his numbers in terms of goal contributions are really, really high. He needs to maintain that level. I think the understanding between the attacking players today was superb. I think they had real purpose and connection and a lot of clarity to attack against them. So he is loving Kai Havertz as we are. On the margins being small, when Bukayo Saka took the penalty to give us the lead, said that's a little one or a huge one because the penalty is a goal and the different scoreline makes a whole difference. But just the courage to take it again, because I'm sure something was around his mind. But it's another year. He's gone through that and he wants to make a difference. And that's the thing. It's a big thing for Saka to step up and take that penalty, given that the exact same game in the season last year was West Ham away, where obviously he missed it. It's big. Ben White's continuously good displays, credit to him. He's always willing to learn, to train, to play in any circumstances when he's feeling good or when he's not feeling good. He's open-minded and he has the desire to win. That's what he made the difference in. 240 people in here and only 91 likes. Let's get it up to 100. Yeah, look, if you could like the video, whilst you're here, please do. It does help it get to more people. And if you're not already subscribed, please do subscribe. On the team celebrating Gabriel's block at the end, I loved that. I loved the celebration of Gabriel's block at the end. Because look, all it meant was that we kept a clean sheet, but they loved that it kept a clean sheet. He said that's really pleasing for all the coaches to see that reaction from the team at 3-0. It's great because that tells you how much they want it, the importance and the focus they put in every single ball. That was an extra bonus today. If Havertz being a different player and a person to the start of the season, he said obviously he's in a different moment. He's got some fantastic players around him. We've tried to create the right environment for him, which I think is very important for any player. And by the way, I think Arteta is bang on there. I think Arteta is bang on that players need good environments. And like Chelsea is a horrible environment to be in at the moment. Arsenal is a great environment. And that's why I think when you look at saying, okay, would you bring in a Madueke or a Mudrick or something, like they could shine. They could shine at Arsenal in a different environment. Like, realistically, Kai Havertz at Chelsea last season didn't look like the player that he is today. And he wouldn't have done if he was still there. You wouldn't be seeing this Kai Havertz if he was still at Chelsea. So I do think that that's big. He was asked about Bukayo Saka's fitness. He said he's fine. He is fine. So that's good. But yeah, that was pretty much it. Honest, if the boss has laughed off the calls for signing a striker in January, no, because you don't know what happens. Stay humble in football. Enjoy the day because you don't know how it's going to be tomorrow. And he is bang on. He is bang on. Can't you just stand in line at the Emirates ticket booth before the game? Can't you just stand in line? That's not a thing, unfortunately. There isn't a ticket booth at the Emirates. That hasn't been a thing for a long time, unfortunately. That's kind of like that's like when your parents tell you to go and drop your CV off at a shop to get a job. It's unfortunately, the game's moved on. The game has moved on. Thoughts on Saka's comments when he said he's struggling for fitness, but whilst he has two legs, he'll play and fight. I mean, it's a good thing, right? You want players that are going to do that, but equally, you know, if he's playing with a knock, it's not ideal. It's not ideal. Finally caught up to a live. Always end up watching it back. I appreciate you watching it back. Honestly, I appreciate everyone that watches it back. It makes a huge difference. So shout out to the people that are here in the live. There are over 200 of you, which is brilliant for a Sunday evening. But also, shout out to the people that watch it back. Just enter the Emirates and sleep there. Do you know what? That's actually what I should have done. That's what I should have done. After the Luton game, I should have just found a hiding spot and just camped out for 8 days. I should have gone to a toilet or something, found a hiding spot. We could have just gone live from inside the Emirates every evening. Kivior to start against Bayern on Tuesday. I think it's going to be Tomiyasu. I think the fact that in both of the last two games, Tomiyasu's been the one that's come on as a sub for Zinchenko. I mean, Kivior, has he even played a minute in the last two games? Did he come on in the end yesterday? I can't remember. But the fact that it's been Tomiyasu coming on for Zinchenko makes me think that that has been Arteta trying to get him up to speed for the game. I can't show up live during weekdays anymore because of the time change. Oh, yeah, that's a shame, actually. I didn't even think about that. Yeah, the time change is an hour different for most people, isn't it? Living on hot dogs and Prime for 8 days? Look, I could do that. I could live on hot dogs and Prime. No problem. Bit of Bovril when it gets cold at night. No Zinchenko to start the next two games. Yeah, Zinchenko won't start. Zinchenko won't. I can guarantee you Zinchenko doesn't start against Bayern based on the fact that he started the last two games. There's no way he'd have started the last two games if Arteta was planning. Well, there's no way he'd have started yesterday if Arteta was planning on starting him against Bayern, because that would be three starts in 7 days after not playing for months. Is the second leg a week after this one? Yes. I think. Or is it the week after? No, I think it is. Because we go Villa, we go Bayern, Villa, Bayern, Wolves. And that's what I'm saying about that Wolves game being tricky. Because if we beat Bayern on the Wednesday and then we play an evening kickoff Saturday game against Wolves, I'm like, you know, I think all of these are an hour out of sync. I think FOTMob's got these all an hour out of sync. In fact, it has got it all on our app sync because it doesn't understand that there's been a clock change. But yeah, I think if we beat Bayern away, you know, that's a big sigh of relief. But then you just got to go again, and then you've got to go again, and then you've got to go again. And by the way, Real Madrid will then be in here somewhere, or Real Madrid or Man City if we've won the game. So it's yeah, it's tricky. I just realised I wasn't showing you the screen then, so you couldn't actually see what I was talking about. Is Gnabry playing? I assume so. Yeah, I assume Gnabry will be playing. Did you see the replay of the penalty for Liverpool? Apparently, it was a dive. Check the video on the shown on Terrace's live. No, yeah, I do. I do think it was a bit of a dive. I do think it was a bit of a dive. But equally, I think like it was just so. It was just such a silly tackle from. It was such a silly tackle from Wan-Bissaka. 125 likes. Let's push it to 150. Come on, get it up to 150 likes. If you haven't liked the stream, please do so. You can just scroll down. Whatever device you're on, just scroll down. You can like it. Liverpool will finish third. They were shocking. They might do. I can't wait for Bayern 5-1 incoming. Arsenal fans humbled once again. All right, Darwin, settle yourself down. You're literally just fuming because you've dropped points against that United team today. We're so much better than Wolves. It could just be tricky because of the circumstances, and they're better than they're getting credit for, especially if they have Neto and Cunha. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. I think Cunha might be out for the season, but I'm not sure. I'm from Norway and have been there two times, last in November and when we won against Burnley. I think I saw ticket booths there. Yeah, but I think you have... I'm not sure you can actually buy tickets from them if you don't already have one. We bottled it so bad, I'm fuming. Fuming. Neto's out till May 2. Yeah, I think they're both out of that game. I do think they're both out of that game. Anyway, it is time for Guess the Gunner, the game where I give you five clues about an ex or current Arsenal player, and you have to guess who it is in the chat. First person to get it right wins the immense pride and respect of the Rory Talks Football community. So get your guesses, get your fingers on your keyboards. We're starting now. Clue number one, this player played 42 games for Arsenal, scoring 6 goals and getting 7 assists. 42 games for Arsenal, 6 goals, 7 assists. They made their Premier League debut in 2017. They only ever won the Community Shield with Arsenal. They began football at Chelsea's Academy. And they are Arsenal's most expensive signing ever. They are Arsenal's most expensive signing ever. Darwin suffering some absolute head loss in and amongst all of that. Bless him. Bless him. He's had a tough day. Well, look, the first person to get it right is Millie. Millie got it right with Rice. She went full caps, wanted to know that we'd seen it. And it is indeed. It is Big Declan. Obviously, the fifth clue made it very easy, but Millie got it way before the fifth clue came up. So congratulations. I think that's your first ever win. I believe that is your first ever win. So congratulations. Vincent was second. Hannah was third. Tom was fourth, and Carl was fifth. So there you go. Congratulations. Another new winner. There you go. Congratulations. I thought you said Arsenal debut 2017. I said Premier League debut 2017. I'm getting trickier with the clues. I said made their Premier League debut in 2017. I did not say made their Arsenal debut in 2017. You've got to listen. You've got to listen to the questions. I just totally lost on that one. Prem debut in 2017 got me. Yeah, I thought it would. Yeah, 6 goals and 7 assists for Arsenal already is pretty impressive. I got sent. Yeah, we've done them. That's a classic, you know, when you're going for an exam and your mum says, make sure you read the question carefully. You've got to listen. Darwin just genuinely has lost his head. Bless him. Bless him. It's all right, Darwin. It's all right. You know? Klopp had a good run. Klopp won the same number of Premier Leagues, right, as Leicester City, as Claudio Ranieri. He had a good run. You know? He had a good run. Following you from Uganda, much love. Much love to Uganda. Much love to Uganda. 42 appearances for us already. Yes. Yeah, 42 appearances for us already, which, again, is very impressive. It is very impressive. His stats are nuts. Yeah, they are. They are nuts. Any other goals in the other games? Tell you what, I'd love it if Spurs drew this game. That would be quite hilarious. Darwin rattled. Yeah, Darwin's rattled. No worries, Icarus. Good to see you. Good to see you. Remember when Klopp got wiped out by Simicass? I do. That was funny. That was funny. I don't think I might board the Gyökeres train. John doesn't want to get on board the Gyökeres train. John, we'll leave you behind. We will leave you behind, John. There's no boarding once he's here. There's no boarding once he's here. No, look, it's fair. There are people that much prefer Isaac, to be fair. There are people that much prefer Isak. And fair enough. Fair enough. You can't complain. You can't complain. But the steam train is flying. We are flying. The train is already crowded. The train is already crowded. Really hope Rice doesn't get a yellow in the Bayern games. Yeah, I forgot about that, actually. I forgot. If Rice gets a booking, he's out of... if he gets a booking in the first leg, he misses the second leg. If he gets a booking in the second leg, he misses the first leg of the semi-final if we get there. So, yeah, Rice has to avoid picking up a booking big time. I have a feeling Arteta would utilize Isak's Martinelli rotation more than at striker. Interesting. I think we should go for Morata or Kolo Muani. Look, right. John. I was open to you not boarding the Gyökeres train. I was open to it. I'll allow it. But the Morata train, that's not a thing. The Morata train is not a thing. That is on strike. That is TFL. That is on strike. It's going nowhere. It doesn't have a driver. It's going nowhere. The driver wants 70 grand a year, and everyone is saying, no, you're not worth 70 grand a year. And the train is stationary. Did you see Murillo almost scored from the halfway line earlier? I didn't see it. I need to go and watch that back. A few people have mentioned it, so I need to go and watch it back. Ah, Spurs are winning. Spurs are winning. Boo. Who scored? Mickey van der Ven. He's actually quite decent, to be fair, van der Ven. If we're up by 3 goals, then do a Mourinho and get booked on purpose to avoid missing the... Yeah. Literally, if we're up by 3 goals in the first leg, which would be miraculous, but if we're up by 3 goals in the first leg, take a booking. Sam, good to see you. Northern Line, Mill Hill East Branch. Van der Ven's screamer, apparently. I'll have to watch it after the stream. Pace Merchant, he has got pace, though. He has got pace, to be fair. I just don't think Gyökeres has experience, and Morata or Griezmann are slightly underrated. Griezmann, I'll give you, but I've seen Morata in the Premier League before. And look, we've got players that have got experience. We don't necessarily need a player that's got experience up top. According to Invert the Wing, Van der Ven is the best centre back in the world. Yeah, I know. Invert the Wing is either a genius in terms of he is operating an incredible troll, or he's mental. Absolutely mental, chicken oriental. Can you tell how to get in the community where you can get tickets? I live in Norway, but going to study in London. There are some WhatsApp groups and stuff that you can join. that help each other get tickets. There are some Facebook groups. But it's kind of a case of you've got to know someone that knows someone in the group, if that makes sense. But other than that, you've just got to enter every ballot and then spend your life on the ticket exchange. That's what I do. 135 likes. Come on, 15 more likes. I'm also from Norway. Love the Norwegians in the chat. Love them. Martin Ødegaard's Barmy Army. Do you like Kolo? I don't think Kolo Muani is better than Gyökeres. I don't. You can rent the tickets off a season ticket holder sometimes if they aren't going every week. Yeah, I get tickets off season ticket holders quite a lot. I get tickets off season ticket holders quite a lot, which has been really helpful this season. But unsurprisingly, every season ticket holder is going to the Bayern game. So, starting lineup for Wednesday. Right now, and it might change after tomorrow's press conference, depending on what Arteta says. But right now, Raya in goal, White, Saliba, Gabriel. I'd go Kivior, but I think it's going to be Tomiyasu. Rice, Jorginho. No. Rice, Partey, Ødegaard, Saka, Martinelli, Havertz. That would be mine. Oh, God. I need to do Guess the Nonguna, but I forgot to look. Hang on. I've got to prepare it. Let me prepare Guess the Nonguna. All right. I feel like I might have done this one before. Hang on. Let me prepare. All right. Partey or Jorginho? I'd go Partey, I think. I think the reason that Partey came off the bench and Jorginho started against Brighton, I think that means that Partey's going to start, which will be quite interesting because it'll be pretty much the first time we've seen Rice, Partey, Ødegaard. In fact, it might literally be the first time we've seen Rice, Partey, Ødegaard starting in midfield, unless we saw it once earlier in the season. I know all three of them started a game, but I can't remember if they all started in the midfield that game. Anyway, Guess the Nonguna. I am going to give you the entire career path of someone who does not and has not played for Arsenal. You have to guess who that player is in the chat. First person to get it right wins the immense pride and respect of the Rory Talks Football community. This player started their career at FC Liefering. They went to RB Salzburg. At RB Salzburg, they went to Hamburg on loan. They then went to RB Leipzig. They went to Wolves on loan, and they went to Wolves permanently. So FC Liefering, RB Salzburg, Hamburg on loan, RB Leipzig permanently, Wolves on loan, Wolves permanently. Bow, bow. Right, let's scroll through. It's not any of them. The first person to get it correct is Vincent Zvolski. It was Huang. It was indeed Huang. Is it Huang He Chan or He Chan Huang? I never know which way around to say it. Kind of like Son Heung Min. I never really know which way you're meant to say it. But it is Huang. So Vincent, congratulations on coming first. Francisco Oliveira, I'm going to assume you were trying to type in Chan. Saka number 7 was third. Pontus was fourth. And Carl was fifth. So there you go. Congratulations. Any? That's Vincent's first win as well. Congratulations, Vincent. That is his first win. Yeah, I figured you meant Chan. Francisco Oliveira. No problem. In Korean, you say the last name first. But which one's his last name? Huang. Korean is Huang He Chan. Okay. So that's the same. So Huang He Chan is the same as saying it as Son Heung Min, I think. Spurs are 3-1 up. Piss off. Pedro Porro. To be fair, Spurs have dominated that game. So, ultimately, you've got Chelsea are about to win and Spurs are about to win. At least Liverpool drew. 2 fifth place finishes. Feels like the end of the Wenger era. Yeah. I'm not even concerned about Spurs. No, nor me. Gibbs White in the summer. Maybe. I'm still kind of interested in Murillo in the summer, to be honest. Potentially. In Norway, Ødegaard and Haaland is like our kings. Even Liverpool fans getting happy if Haaland or Ødegaard doing well. Oh, there you go. Ødegaard should be your king. I'll be honest. Ødegaard should be your king. Haaland doesn't care about Norway enough. The amount of times that he fakes injuries to get out of international duty, Ødegaard should be the one true king of Norway. That Emery gamble against City sure worked out well for him. Yeah, I'm so glad that backfired. I hope we stuff him. To be honest, right, I'll take any sort of win, but I would love it if we absolutely batter Emery at the Emirates. I would love it. What's with Madison's ego? What did he do? What did James Madison do then? Haaland was born in England, plastic. Haaland's not even Norwegian. Well, he's kind of Norwegian. Oh, they've got Oscar Bob as well. Yeah, to be fair, they've got Oscar Bob. Could it be Saka or someone like Havertz or Jorginho? It is Saka, right? And to be fair, I think Saka's what? Taken 5 and scored 5 or taken 6 and scored 6 this season? So I've got no issue with Saka taking them. He scored all of them this season. It could be Jorginho. It could be Kai Havertz. Martin Ødegaard's penalties have been fantastic. I mean, the brilliant thing is, look, when games go to penalties, we've got a lot of strong penalty takers. That's the truth. Why the Emery dislike? Thought he was a nice guy, just not the right fit for us. No, I agree. But the way he gifted Man City a win during the week just annoyed me. Like, I get it. He's doing it right. You know, he's doing whatever he feels like he needs to do for his team. But it annoyed me on Wednesday when he made those changes against City. Because they could have got points against City. You refresh the ticket exchange button 5 times and it blocks you out, for fuck's sake. What are you supposed to do? Yeah, it's so annoying. So in the end, right, this is how I do it. I've got 2 phones. I've got my laptop. I've got my PC. And on the phone, you can use the app and you can use the, like, Safari browser. So effectively, between that, on 2 phones and the laptop and the PC, I can basically rotate between 6 effectively. So when one dies, I do another. So effectively, I can do 6. It's another United, but this time it's Sheffield United, who have equalized in the 93rd minute with Ollie McBurney has just equalized to make it 2-2 against Chelsea in the 93rd minute. Oh my God. Chelsea fans in the space of a week have drawn against Burnley and Sheffield United. Oh, you love to see it. How long does it block you out for? Normally about half an hour. It normally blocks you out for about half an hour. Oh my God. That is sensational. I'll tell you what, that doesn't really... I mean, where does that leave them in the league? It leaves them 9th place, 3 points behind Newcastle with a game in hand, 4 points behind West Ham with 2 games in hand, 5 points behind Man United with 1 game in hand. So, there you go. We've hit 150 likes. Much appreciated. You are all legends. Thank you very much for hitting 150 likes. It's been a good stream. There's been over 200 of you here for most of the stream, which has been really good. People actually love Ødegaard more. He loves the nation, and everybody thinks he is so much more nicer than Haaland. Absolutely. Ødegaard is the GOAT. Erdegaard is the goat. If you don't refresh on the ticket exchange, do new tickets even come up? No, you have to refresh. You have to refresh. And then if you refresh a bit quickly, it kicks you out. It's really annoying. It is really annoying. Look, anyway, that is going to be the end of the stream. Thank you so much for joining on a Sunday evening. We are top of the league. Say we are top of the league. It's been a good one. Tomorrow, 6:30, as normal, we'll be back for the Bayern Munich preview. But until then, enjoy the end of your weekend. Have a good evening. And thank you very much for joining. And I will catch you all tomorrow.